Hey Macho and Edgar here. I'm so glad to be back and I want to talk to you guys about something more retrospective, more thinky, right? Yes, I do have a changing dog lighty thing and it's very distracting. So if you ever get bored at one section in the video, just watch the dog. So I wanted to talk about how I chose my major and then maybe that will help you guys choose your major. Because choosing, and not only is does this video talk about that, but I also want to express how to find what works for you in your life, whether it's college, finding your college major, or finding an interest, right? Or sticking to something that you really like. So I started, as you guys know, I'm a computer science major. I did not start as a computer science major. I started as a music education major. I know, crazy, right? How did I even get to that? Because they are two extremely different skill sets, completely different degrees. And the reason why I chose music education as my very first degree was because I've done music my whole life. I've been playing the piano up to this point. To the uploading of this video, I've been playing piano for 11 years. I played French horn all of middle school, all of high school, and like my first semester of college. So I've been playing French horn for a long time and music has just always been a part of me. I just want to say that if you want to do music, go ahead and do it. But there just were not a lot of opportunities in my area where I live, not a lot of job openings in music. And I knew that if I studied music education, I would be limiting to myself to a very specific field, like being a band director or a choir director. And at first, I kind of wanted to do that, but at 19, 20 years old, it's really hard to figure out what you want to do in your life at that age. You know, I mean, your decision is going to affect your entire life, how much money you make, what kind of house you have, you know, if you can afford this or that. And it's really tough. So I congratulate every single one of you out there. I've had a lot of subscribers recently. I thank you so much because you are watching my videos and on this little corner of YouTube. And you know, I just congratulate everybody who is even in school or even not even has, okay, maybe you're not even in school. Maybe you just love to learn. You know, I have teachers that watch my videos. You know, the fact that you want to spread knowledge, that you want to give knowledge, that you took so many years in studying something and now you want to give that back. I think that's a beautiful thing. And I congratulate all of you for making it this far. And even if you have not made any decisions yet, like going to school or anything, you know, just the fact that you decide to learn something. Or you want to learn, let's say learn a language or learn how to cook or learn something. Learn. Learning is life, okay? And if you're not learning, then you're not living, right? I mean, that's how I think of life. You must learn. There's so much out there, so much information. There's always something that you can do. There's always something that you're talented in, right? And I realized that when I wanted to become a music major. However, I realized that, as I said before, financially I didn't think it was going to be okay for me. And I was talking with a family member and they were like, well, why don't you change your major, go to a different school? I did actually go to a different school. I had quit school actually and I started working, just doing normal adulting stuff. And I was like, no. I want to go back to school. Right? And so this is to show you that it's never too late. I did not start college at 18. I did not go to a high school where I was able to graduate with an associate's degree at 18. I did not. I started school when I was about 20 or 21. So I started later than some of the people around me, right? I mean, I was in a trigonometry class last year. There was someone in my class who was 16. I was like, 16 and you're in trigonometry? What was I doing at 16? Let's not talk about that. But I will say, like, I thought about it and I'm like, You know, that's really interesting. I never thought that I could do something else, because I've always done music, piano, composing, singing, writing, music, everything to do with music. And you don't want to limit yourself either. Just because you've been doing something your whole life doesn't mean that that has to be your only focus, right? And so someone told me, why don't you do something that you're going to like, but it's also going to allow you to be financially stable. So I was like, okay, well, what could that be? And they said computer science. And I'm like, I like computers. I like technology. And then I learned a little bit about what programming is and programming languages. And I was like, wow, I kind of like that. You know, I love languages. As you guys know, I speak three languages, and I love to learn languages. I love rules. I love grammar. I'm a very big grammar person. I love grammar. I love to notate grammar in books and just study grammar for hours. And even though it's not always the most applicable thing ever, I love it. So I was like, okay, well, why don't I do computer science? And I've fallen in love with it. I love it. I think it's awesome. It's there are so many job prospects. It is the fastest in growing industry in the world. Computers are everywhere. Everything is digital. There are phones, there are computers, there are apps, there are programmers. You know, for example, what you are using right now, YouTube, watching me, somebody made that, somebody programmed that somewhere, right? And I want to be that person to program apps where that can do all sorts of things, right? So I still do music. I am a worship leader at my church. I still play piano. Heck, sometimes I'll give a piano lesson here and there. I love to read music. I love to compose sheet music. I love to write songs, right? So I'm still involved in music just as much as I was before. I'm just studying my career. I'm doing a career in something very different because I like that too. Be versatile, right? And if you don't really, really know, try it out. I remember I read a website and it's like, oh, I can't remember the percentage, most college kids, an X percent amount of college students change their major. And I remember when I first started college, I was like, I'm not one of those kids. I'm not going to waste my money. I'm not going to waste my time. I know what I want. Okay. I know what major I want. Well, yeah, I was one of those people. I actually changed my major, and I never thought I was going to be that person. But it's okay. You're still discovering yourself. Again, you're young, and there's still time while you are here on this earth to figure out what you want to do. So that is all I have for you. Hopefully this inspired you guys. Please like and subscribe, and make sure you give me some comments as to what you would like me to speak about next. All right? Thank you, guys. Have a great day.